Sanan, the captain and chief of construction of the Falcon Robotics AUV team. We are from Carhen High School, and this is our second year competing in the RoboSub competition. Last year, we learned a lot, and we have came back with a new and improved AUV that we could build upon for the next 2 years.
Hello, my name is Dylan Day, and I am the chief designer. One of our key new improvements for AUV was increasing the density of our electronics packaging system, allowing us to create a smaller hole in the lighter AUV. This was done using a rapid prototype 3D lattice structure that allows us to put square and rectilinear devices into round and curvilinear holes. Phoenix Analysis and Design Technologies provided us with a lattice structure that I designed using Autodesk Inventor. Our new AUV is now half the weight of our old AUV, so we feel that we've done a good job increasing the density of our electronics package.
Hello, my name is John Rangel, I'm the head programmer of the Falcon Robotics AUV team. Last year we had a mess of programming. So this year we developed better software architecture, got more organized, and now we're able to develop code a lot better than last year. We've also developed a graphical user interface to allow us to change code in real time without having to get into the code itself.
Hello, I am Desiree Sanders and I work on the electrical systems. This year we designed our power system to match exact requirements of the mission, thus reducing the size and weight of the batteries. For program testing and development, we created an electrical tether that allows us to use surface voltage without changing the buoyancy.
Our new AUV is called Sovereign Falcon, and it is a new platform that we plan to use for the next 2 years. This allows us to focus on programming and not bother with designing or building a new AUV each year. We designed Sovereign Falcon to be robust and advanced. The only thing really separating us from the best in the field is a 6-year programming gap.
That is why we really want to focus on programming. We believe we have matched some of the top teams as far as components go, but now we want to focus on our major weakness. We also want to partner with some of those top teams so that we can hopefully lessen the gap of knowledge between us and them.
For this year's competition, we are really gunning for the bonus points. Our strategy is to do the minimum tasks as needed to qualify for these points. So we designed an AUV that can navigate using a compass, gyro, and as well as vision processing. And also on our AUV, we can drop markers and shoot torpedoes.
The structure of the AUV is all aluminum with 3 pressure chambers and a 3-piece internal frame. One of the pressure chamber houses all of the AUV's electronics, while the other two house both of the lithium polymer batteries. The 3-piece internal frame consists of the main frame, which is mounted horizontally, while the other two minor frames are mounted to keep the hole in place.
We have a special analyzer station on the robot this year that's called the Triplex, which has recently been invented and patented. What makes it special is that it is 50 times stronger than conventional analyzer station. This was invented by Walt Allen and Michael Weaver. We hope this will keep our AUV in top conditions for over the next 2 years.
The vision processing on our AUV is done using the AForge.net framework. It has a lot of useful vision methods, including, but not limited to, object tracking, edge detection, color filters, and much, much more.
Many of our sensors and interfaces are plug-and-play USB devices. We try to use as many off-the-shelf products as possible. And we also like to view our AUV project as a systems integrated one. Therefore, we like to avoid making our own custom-made circuits and mechanisms, if at all possible.
For the torpedo launcher and the rocket dropper, there were no off-the-shelf products, so we had to construct them ourselves. Nevertheless, we kept it simple. Both of them use sprinkler valve technology and are extremely easy to construct. The torpedoes themselves are an off-the-shelf child's toy called a torpedo.
We even have a few special capabilities that we hope will give us an advantage. One example is our motorized lenses mounted onto our Guppy Firewire machine cameras. This gives us the ability to adjust the focal length, iris, and focus remotely or autonomously. We never have to open our pressure chamber to adjust anything. We can control or adjust anything remotely.
Our thruster geometry also gives us unparalleled maneuverability. We have our thrusters mounted at 45 degree angles to the geometric square of the AUV. This allows us to get essentially what is called vector drive and allows us to move the AUV in any direction.
So as you can see, we have come to a competition with a fairly capable robot and designed it with room for improvement in the coming years. We hope to do well this year and hopefully win the event in one of the coming years.
Thanks for listening to us, and thank you to AVSI, Office of Naval Research, and our sponsors. Cheer us on as we dive into the deep end.